There was a faint twinkle in Philip's eyes, but he only said, "You have seen nothing that would suggest there is anything in the rumors about a rising?" Dredian laughed. "No," he said. "A bushman came in and told me Tuesday, was getting ready to cut the white men's throats, and when he asked for half a sovereign's worth of cotton, I gave it to him. Next day another fellow came along and said the first one was a fraud and didn't know the right tale. He was prepared to tell it to me, but he wanted twice as much cotton. There was, however, no making anything of what he had to say, except that I was not to believe the other fellow's story, and the fact is, I'm getting skeptical about the thing." Phillips lighted a cigar. "Well," he said dryly, "we will hope you're right, but the one white man who could tell us what is going on is Galatly." There was silence after this, and Phillips sat staring thoughtfully into the blue cigar smoke. He knew nothing definite about what was happening in the bush, but he suspected a good deal, and one thing was plain. Any success the Chief Tuesday might, if he came out, achieve would start a conflagration that a strong battalion of West Indias could scarcely extinguish. He had also lighted his second cigar when the hoarse cry of a sentry rose from beyond the stockade, and there was a shouting in the bush. Then a policeman came up the stairway and raised his hand in salute. "White man lib," he said. Phillips glanced at Jardine. "Galatly," he said. "We will hear something now." Then they went down together and the stockade gate swung open. A West India sergeant stood in front of it holding a lantern, and a bare-legged policeman, with bayonet glinting over his ordered rifle on either side. Then, amidst a pattern of wary feet, the bearers came in, gasping, thorn-scarred and tattered, with fear in their dusky faces and a hammock jolting in the midst of them. They apparently vastly relieved when the stockade gate swung to behind them. "Halt," said Jardine. "This way with the lantern, Sergeant. You seem to have come along in a hurry, Mr. Galatly." There was no answer, and Jardine laid his hand on the hammock awning, and for no apparent reason, stopped a moment. Still, he could see the vague terror in the bearers' faces. Then, while the sergeant raised the lantern, he flung the awning back and gasped. Galatly, who did not move at all, was staring at him with glassy eyes. "Good heavens," he said hoarsely, "the man is dead!" There was a murmur of voices, for the bearers had also seen, but Phillips, who asked a few questions, raised his hand. "Silence there," he said. "Bearers march. Bring that lantern to the armory, sergeant." The bearers shuffled forward, and when Phillips made a sign, the sergeant, who did not seem desirous of lingering, went out with them, leaving the white men alone with Galatly. Phillips glanced at him gravely.